Thank you. May the God of hope give you the fullness of peace, and may the Lord of life be always with you. In the waters of baptism, Seamus died with Christ and rose with him in new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
Thank you. Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Good morning, everyone. Welcome as we gather together in faith to offer this morning this record mass for the soul of Seamus, and I extend my sympathy and prayerful support to those from our parish community and beyond who cannot be here in person today owing to the present restrictions. I also welcome friends and colleagues who are watching over the internet from a distance, especially those in New York, where it is, I think, 6 a.m. in the morning, so it's an early start for them, and I love them. This was Seamus' home, but it became his second home, in a sense, after moving to New York in July of 1982, as you know, working as a joiner and establishing his carpentry business there. And his fellow members of New York, Belleeks, and County Adventures Tractor Clubs, which were a big part of Seamus' life, offered their sympathy and their prayers at this time. And we offer our support to Seamus' sisters, Marie, Anne, and Veronica, his brothers, Joseph, Sean, Laurence, and Lowell, his nieces and nephews, grandnieces and nephews, and all the extended family. People, we are reminded, as I said at our funeral on Tuesday, people are the greatest gifts to us as family. And God gave a great gift in Seamus, and even though we are certainly saddened at his passing, the gift of his life that has been taken away from us, we are grateful for the gift that he gave through his life, through his 61 years. So as we begin to offer this Eucharist for the happy repose of his soul, let us now ask God's forgiveness as we call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You were seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who have mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant Seamus, for whom you perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, free from the bonds of mortality, he may come before your face through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please now be seated, and I invite Marie and Shane. Now please come forward and lead us in our scripture readings, and our psalm, and Alleluia will be sung.
Thank you. took the call out, the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, we should comfort one another. The word of the Lord.
Seamus' tragic fall at his home in New York on Sunday evening, from which he never recovered, his life support fell silent on the 13th of this month. And so Seamus began his final journey on the path, we pray, to eternal life with God. And the day a person dies, we all, his family and his friends and neighbours, begin to tell their story. We tell our own personal stories of that person's life, however short or long it has been. It is relived and turned over again and again, with tears and with laughter, remembering all the joys and the sorrows, the successes and failures, from childhood memories with family to cherished memories of good friend and colleague. Seamus has been taken from us tragically at the young age of 61. And you, his family, are left with the sorrow and emptiness of his loss, and maybe feeling a little cheated by his death. Cheated because maybe in a sense there was still so much more for Seamus to do. I know he planned to return home permanently. So much more to achieve and to give, but sadly all these plans are no more. And what is left now is maybe slight confusion and only more questions. We can understand death, some deaths, the death of an elderly person after a long and happy life. But so much in life, as we often know, like the times we live in, does not make sense. And for a death like Seamus's, we find it difficult to see the purpose and maybe the meaning. But God's ways are not our ways. In the end, life itself seems full of contradictions and confusions. We need and want life very much to make sense, and yet today nothing makes any sense. But if you go back to our scriptures there in the booklet, St. Paul, and throughout our readings of Scott, St. Paul has told us that we are a people of hope. He tells us not to grieve like those who have no hope. We have faith that gives us hope. Yet even as people of faith, we experience the same things in life that others do. We experience its ups and downs, its joys and misfortunes, and its deepest sorrows. And in it, in all of this, it reminds us, and Paul reminds us, that we have a hope that others do not have. That ours is not a hope we find in life, in its meaning and purpose. It is a hope that transcends all of these, because it is not born here. It is a hope that is eternal, that comes into our oftentimes dark and confusing world to give it life, to give us life. And we see it on the cross, as we heard in that story from our gospel, the story of Calvary, with Christ dying there for us, so that we might share in a new and eternal life. It is on a day like today we need the presence, certainty, and the support of God, or we simply cease to exist. As I said, God walks with us continually, and it is only our faith in times like these that will make sense of today and help us to see beyond Seamus's tragic and untimely death to the new life we pray he is now enjoying with God and his parents and those he loved and believed in this life. Seamus had a great warm and generous welcome to those who would visit him at his home in New York, and also when he would come home, he was generous, certainly with his time and with his love. He would be found here to my left, just back in the middle of the church, here for Sunday Mass, giving gratitude to God, in prayer for family and friends, and finding solace and nourishment in God's Word and in the Eucharist. And as long as we have Christ, we have hope that despite all the disappointments and sorrows in life, we find meaning and purpose in our belief and faith in Christ. This is our faith, and this is our hope. So as we commend our brother Seamus to God's mercy today, it is that faith and that hope we claim. Before the cross of life, there is simply nothing else. Before the cross of Christ, all is transformed into hope, because he is a son of God. So we pray with faith and hope that Seamus will find now peace and the joy in his home that Christ has prepared for him. We pray too that as we continue standing before the cross of Christ, he will bring to our grief and to our emptiness, maybe in confusion, the hope of the resurrection and comfort in our sorrow today. May he rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. to our prayer of the faithful. So I now invite Ronan, Laura, Stephen, and Ian, and I please to come forward and lead us in our intentions. Let us stand together. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his rest in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe you. And through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. Listen now to the needs which we place before you on this day.
We pray for Seamus for his day. May God now welcome him into his heavenly home and turn him happiness and peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those whose lives are dedicated to caring for the sick, and in particular we pray for the doctors, nurses, chaplain and staff at Co.Armagh University Hospital in New York, who cared for Seamus during his accident. May God reward their goodness and kindness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
You are in indeed, holy O Lord, the fount of all things. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks for it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In the same way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence here this morning and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Eamon, Michael, and Sean, our bishops, and all your holy people. Remember your servant Seamus, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our many sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, first class, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Laurence O'Toole, St. Patrick Peel, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
We stand together, and at the Saviour's command and for the divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all worry, fear, and distress, as we await the blessing and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you and your families at this time. And with your spirit. And let us take a moment in silence and pray for the peace of Christ in our lives at this time. take away the sins of our world and mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of our world and mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of our world and grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
cherish his memory and let it live on. You can cry and close your mind, be happy and turn your back. Or you can do what you would want, say, open your eyes, love and go on.
Before we go our separate ways, now let us take leave of our brother Seamus. May our farewell express our affection for him, be it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. And as we now pray for the soul of Seamus in silence, we sprinkle his coffin with holy water, a sign and a symbol of his baptism in the Lord, and incense, sign and symbol of our prayers rising to heaven, that the Lord may have mercy on his soul this day. Response, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, the angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ your God, you take you to himself, and the angels lead you to the side of Abraham.
Receive your soul and the
Lord. Eternal rest grant unto Seamus, O Lord, and let the perpetual light shine upon. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father, of mercies, we commend our brother Seamus, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Seamus in this life, and your signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Seamus, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith and hope until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with our brother Seamus forever and ever. Amen. In peace, let us now take our brother Seamus to his place of rest.
Our brother Seamus has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us now assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother Seamus. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. We read in sacred scripture, our true home is in heaven, and Jesus Christ, whose return we long for, will come from heaven to save us. O God, by whose mercy the faithful departed find rest, we ask you to bless this grave. Send your holy angel to watch over this grave, as we now bury the body of our brother Seamus. Deliver his soul from every bond of sin, that he may rejoice in you with your sins forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. If you just want to lift the coffin up off and make him
Because God has chosen to call our brother Seamus from this life to himself, we now commit his body to the earth, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother Seamus to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last day. Dear friends, in reverence, let us now pray to God, the source of all mercies. You raise the dead to life, give to our brother Seamus eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Seamus and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Comfort us now in our sorrow at the death of Seamus. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all who are buried in the cemetery, remembering today his parents, Seamus's parents, Vera and James, and all the deceased of the Crilly family. May their suffering be lessened. May their joy be increased. May the light of glory shine in them. And may they rest in peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us
from all evil. Amen.
Loving God, from whom all life proceeds, and by whose hand the dead are raised again, though we are sinners, you wish always to hear us. Accept the prayers we offer now in sadness for your servant Seamus. Deliver his soul from death, number him among your saints, and clothe him with the robe of eternal salvation, to enjoy forever the delights of your eternal kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We offer up the first mystery of the Most Holy Rosary, the Resurrection, the glorious mystery. The Lord may grant to Seamus eternal peace and rest. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee we cry for banished children of thee. To thee we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, the eyes of mercy towards us. And after this arise, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be worthy of the promises of Christ.
May the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help those who mourn for Seamus, and accompany all of us in our time of need. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. And let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear now your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless and protect you and your families, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go in the peace of the risen Christ.
Thanks be to God. Yeah.